My name is Jeremy Craycraft, and I teach at the College of St. Scholastica. We were reaching out to our extended campuses, in this case, St. Cloud. We at the main university, or the main college, think it's important that we connect to the campuses that are still part of our community. And one of the great ways to do that, of course, is to share our music that we do at the main campus with those extended sites. So we were here providing a concert, a meet and greet, and just an opportunity for students to meet some of our colleagues and peers from other institutions. The steel drum itself originated around 1935. Of course, it was in the pan yards of Trinidad and Tobago in poor lower class neighborhoods with basically generations removed former slaves. And so these people were literally making music for fun. They started hitting on biscuit tins, metal barrels, things out of the kitchen, and lo and behold, they discovered that if you pound on some of these dents, you could hear a pitch. So what happens is over the next 20 years or so, they develop the pan, which is essentially now an oil barrel that has been hammered out and then hammered up, and it creates these wonderful little bumps that when you strike them produce pitches. It's been basically improved upon for the last 70 years to the point where now what you heard tonight was just a fantastic timbre made out of very thin metal.
The thing that I like most about the hand drum ensemble is that I really love the chance to be able to just go express myself musically, and it helps me deal with stress too. But I want to be able to keep playing drums. I've been playing drums in second grade. It's been a part of me all my life, and I really wasn't ready to give it up.
Something that I like most about the djembe is it's very diverse, and it's much fun playing it. And when we are on set, we get like students to come up and play and practice with us.
The hand drum ensemble plays traditional hand drum music from places in West Africa. In addition to, we have a piece from Puerto Rico. And so it's very good to be able to not only play really good music, but also learn about the cultures from where they're from, learn about the cultures themselves, the significance of the songs they're playing. Not only does it help enhance your musical talent, it helps expand your knowledge of other cultures.
One of the great things about St. Scholastica is that primarily most of these students are in other professional degree programs. They do music because they're passionate about it, they love it, they've done it in high school, they'd like to continue it in college, but they know that it's not where they want to make their money as a career. So they're participating just for the joy of participating.